Hey guys, it's Frenzied, and I wanted to post a review of my favorite knife. It's the Benchmade 707 Sequel, and I'll compare it to a couple of other knives here that I've carried daily, but what we've got here are three different variations of the same exact knife. Wonderful knives if you're not familiar with them or don't have them, never heard of them. It's a 3-inch, actually it's like 2.95-inch blade, wonderful shape to it. I'm not sure if that shows up better than the probably the black one I'll use. The shape is ideal, in my opinion, for everyday carry, at least for my usage of it. It's not too thick, which is great for slicing. The handle material is, the scales are aluminum, so very lightweight. It's got a patch of G10 material here that makes it ideal for just kind of holding on to. It's just small and takes up so little room in my pocket, but yet that blade is so large, given that size, and you close it up, that tip goes all the way to the edge down there. I know you can't see it because it's dark in there, but that blade is the entire length of this knife, basically. And I love that it's that compressed and compact. They open so smooth. A little flip will shoot that guy open with no issues at all. It's an axis lock, so you can also just flip it back and forth as well. You don't even need to touch the flipper or the thumb studs if you don't want to. It's tip-up carry, which I also like, uses the great Benchmade clip here that I've come to love. I've had no issues with it at all, and it doesn't scratch and mar like, gosh, I don't know if I have one to show you here. What kind that do? Like this one, which is like a painted material, and I'm told that they scratch up and mar. They're glossy, too. So I definitely like the clip on this. There's nothing about this knife that I dislike, and I think that's the first knife I've ever had that I can say that about, and that's the honest truth, guys. I like the clip for use as a traction point too, and this is maybe the only knife I've ever had that, in sitting there on the couch while I'm watching a TV show or just killing time, you know how you flip them open and closed all the time, I have not cut myself off. And that's because of these aluminum scales. It puts your fingers far enough away from where these things close down that using that clip there, my grip on it, my fingers never get in the way of that knife blade closing. And I tell you what, that is not the case with other knives like this Griptilian here. These Griptilians, I do that on these guys, and I've chunked off part of my finger there multiple times on different knives, playing with them, flipping them back and forth. And this is one of those, and that's a small thing, and it's probably just an issue for me, but it makes me love these 707s even more. Previous to these 707s, I'll talk a little bit about that, I did use and pretty much like this mini barrage, and I still like it a lot. It's a very nice knife, but it's considerably, or at least it feels to be heavier and bulkier, and given that it's the same size blade, basically, just slightly wider towards the tip. I don't see the advantage of carrying this other than the assisted feature, which I actually, it's not a great feature for me. I don't feel like I need it. So, again, superior for, in my opinion, the 707. Size and weight, and don't need that assist feature. I carried this guy for a while, Sierra KT Ripple 2. This guy's got, in my opinion, a flaw with the clip here. It tended to work its way out of my pocket. But other than that, I actually really like this knife. It's... I don't like the flipper systems in general, though, and I still don't. Even though this one, that's your only option, it's got no thumb studs. I considered going ahead and using it, you know, a lot for everyday carry, but the issue with the clip prevented it. Nice knife, though. I mean, if you guys are into the flipper systems, beautiful knife, wonderful knife, lightweight. A lot of the stuff I've talked about with this one is true of this. This is even thinner. And the clip placement, because I'm not using the clip as a traction point on this knife, I did not cut myself on this plane with it either. Previous to that, I used these Spyderco Sages. There's a Sage 2 in titanium. Nice knives. I actually used a Sage 1 in carbon fiber. For a while, I was on a titanium kick. I still like them. I like the frame locks. But to be honest, I probably, of these two, of the Sage 2 or the Sage 1, to be honest, I probably prefer this one, the Sage 1. It's, I don't know, feels maybe a little lighter. It feels more grippy, that's for sure. Just feels friendlier, and I carried it longer, so I really like it. It's a nice knife. Previous to those guys, Spyderco Persistence. If you're on a budget and you got 30 bucks to spend, and that's about it for an everyday carry knife, right here's your knife. Go out and get it. You can't go wrong, guys. Seriously, it's every possible carry option: tip up, tip down, left or right. Great leaf-shaped blade, pretty much. 2.75, something like that, inch long. Wonderful. There's nothing wrong with this. It's made in China. That's the one thing that's wrong with it. That's a good thing about the Benchmades, too, and that is becoming more and more important to me. In the past, it was a huge deal for me. I got into some Japanese sports cars, and I lost the Made in America thing because of that. And, I don't know, the recent recession and everything, and the everything else, it's growing with me again, so I do like to buy American when I can. Previous to the Persistence, my everyday carry knife was this one, a CRKT M2102G. It's actually a pretty nice knife. The Persistence is cheaper, though, and so I would definitely recommend the Persistence over it. Previous to that, I got into smaller, I was carrying much smaller knives, and this, we're talking way back into the 1990s at this point now. This is a knife I've had a long time. It's a Boker Gamma, little tiny ceramic bladed knife. I used it when I was working for law enforcement. I could carry it into secure areas okay. Even though I was with law enforcement, they still had to. I had to go through metal detectors and such. I don't think it would work anymore, by the way, guys. They've tightened down security for that kind of stuff. Previous to that, I would always carry Swiss Army knives, like this Winger. What was that, Soldier? I think I bought that on eBay, actually from a guy in Switzerland when they first come out. And then this Victorinox Tinker, I believe, that I got for Christmas several decades ago. And then previous to that, my very first everyday carry knife that I can recall is this Gerber LST. So there you go. There's my history with everyday carry knives, my very favorite knives, the ones that basically I am no longer looking for an everyday carry knife. I found them right here. 707 Sequels, guys. Go out, buy some.